Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 2.2, Problem 5. This is Section 2.2, Problem number 5. It says, draw a histogram for the data from Problem number 4. So what we have on the board right now is the answer from problem number 4. So number 4, the question only had the black numbers showing and we had to fill in the red ones. So now that we have all of it, the next question says, draw a histogram for this or the bar graph for it. Again, specialized bar graph where the bars have to be vertical, they have to touch. So these different classes will be the different bars and the frequencies will determine the heights of the bars. So my biggest bar will have a height of 31. Now, I'm reluctant to draw 31 little lines, and I certainly could. It's tedious, and it wouldn't even really make a good-looking bar graph to have that many little lines. It'd be too cramped and packed. I would rather have an interval where I'll hit the 31 easily. The two sensible choices, I could go by threes, and I would need 10 or 11 lines, or by fives, where I would need 6 or 7 lines. Either one, I'll probably choose to go with the fives. You could do either one as long as you label it clearly. You could even pick different. You could have a number scale of 2.86 if you like, as long as you label it, though I wouldn't recommend that. But it wouldn't be wrong as long as you label it. So I'll do the histogram right next to it. So if I'm going to go by fives, 6 lines would get me up to 30, right? 6 times 5 is 30, so I'll go one more. I need at least 7. 7 or more, if I do more, that's okay, but 7 is the least I should have. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And that's enough. You could put in more if you like if you had room, you could end it at 50, which is a natural stopping point, which would be easy, but 7 will be good. So I'll label them 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35. And that number scale that goes up to 35 will accommodate my highest bar of 31 and then everything else that's a little bit less. So the first class has a frequency of 17. So the first bar will have a height of 17. Now I don't have 17 exactly on my number scale. If you look, you won't find a 17. But I can figure that 17.5 is exactly the halfway point between 15 and 20. 17 is pretty close, so it'd be a tiny bit less in height than the halfway point for 17. So by eye, I'll estimate that. Again, my bar has to be vertical if it's a histogram. The next class has a frequency of 23. So the next bar will have a height of 23. Now, like the 17, I don't have a 23 on my number scale, but I can estimate it. Between 20 and 25, exactly in the middle is 22.5. So 23 is a tiny bit higher than 22.5. So my next bar would be slightly higher than that halfway point. Again, the bars should touch. So I will continue the edge of the previous bar up to that height of 23. And get the bar to be about the same width. And there's the second bar for the histogram. Now, the next class has a frequency of 20, so the next bar will have a height of 20. Now, in this particular case, I do have exactly 20 on my number scale, so just try and hit that 20 as close as we can. Again, the bars touch, so just continue the next bar from the edge of the previous bar. Like that. Now the next class has a frequency of 31, so the next bar will have a height of 31. That's going to be the highest bar. Again, I don't have a 31 exactly, but I have 30, so I'll go a little past the 31 by eye, maybe about here, a little more than a quarter of the way past the 31, or a little less rather. So by eye, that looks about right. And again, I'll continue the edge of the previous bar up to that height of 31. And finally, the last bar has a the last class has a frequency of 9, so the last bar will have a height of 9. Now, like some of the others, I don't have 9 exactly on the number scale, but you can figure it'd be a little less than the 10 in terms of its height. About like that. So now I have all the bars at a height determined by that number scale, but I do have to label the bottom of my histogram. I can't leave the bottom blank. So there are a few different methods for labeling the bottom. This book that we've used uses a pretty common one. What they do is they put the lower class limits, the smaller values from each class, right under the edge of each bar. So the first lower class limit is 28. It goes under the left edge of the first bar, 28. Now, the next lower class limit is 43. It goes under the edge of the next bar, 43. The next lower class limit is 58. So that 58 goes under the edge of the next bar. The next lower class limit is 73. So that 73 goes under the edge of the next bar. And the next lower class limit is 88. So the 88 goes under the edge of the next bar. But now what happens is you wind up with the last edge that doesn't have a label under it. And there is no next class. But you can just say pretend that there is a next class at some point in the future. If the last class we have ends at 102, the next class to have no gap and no overlap would have to begin at 103 if there ever is a next class, and that would be the next lower class limit. That's what would go under that last edge, 103, and now the bottom is labeled and the left side is labeled, and we're done.